A setback reports giant ICTSI as South Africa's High Court blocks its bid to operate the country's biggest port in Durban. The court in Johannesburg halted the selection of ICTSI as operating partner of state-owned Transnet for Pier 2 of Durban's container terminal. It acted on the petition of the Danish firm Maersk, which was a rival in the bidding for the contract. The company of tycoon Enrique Razon was awarded a 25-year contract in July last year. The Philippine concessionaire was to get 49% stake in the Durban terminal for an investment reportedly totaling to $618 million. ICTSI says while it respects the court's decision, it also disagreed with the move. It also vowed to counter the case.
Philippine ICT Department calling for a more resilient digital nation as it hosts the Philippine Critical Information Infrastructure Protection Summit. Let's get more details on that from our correspondent Andrea Taguines. Andy, go ahead.
Stanley, the Department of Information and Communications Technology, or DICT, hopes the cybersecurity bill would be certified as urgent by the president soon so that it would have a higher chance of being passed into law before Congress goes on a break ahead of the election season. The proposed measure, which would mandate organizations that operate critical information infrastructure like telcos, major transportation hubs, power grids, and water supply systems, to report to the government when they are hit with cyber attacks, is now on the agenda of the Legislative Executive Development Advisory Committee, which is chaired by President Marcos. According to DICT Undersecretary Jeffrey D., when we interviewed him at the sidelines of the CII Protection Summit, if not this Congress, they expect the measure to be passed by lawmakers during the beginning of the 20th Congress. The salient points of the proposed bill include monetary and administrative penalties for non-compliant CII operators and the forming of a cybersecurity regulatory body. But D noted that based on their initial consultations with the private sector, their request was that they be given 24 months to comply with the new rules. D stressed the need for this measure, saying it is to prevent possible glitches or the breakdown of critical and essential services. Just over the past 7 months of this year, D said the DICT's National Computer Emergency Response Team already had to deal with more than 2,200 cybersecurity incidents targeting government agencies, state universities and colleges, as well as telcos. But he believes there is still an underreporting of such threats because the private sector is not required to disclose these matters to the DICT under current laws. He said the Philippine government is also open to having public-private partnership projects for CII protection. For its part, the Japan International Cooperation Agency, or JICA, said it is working with the DICT to train its personnel and enhance the agency's ICT capabilities. It also offers educational opportunities for Filipino students to study in Japan. Since as it stands, the DICT said there are only three local schools offering bachelor degrees in cybersecurity. JICA said it is also already incorporating cybersecurity features for ongoing infrastructure projects under the Marcos administration's Build Better More program, like in the Metro Manila Subway project and the North-South Commuter Railway. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Andy.